Okay. Hi.
Hey.
Boy, it seemed like the last video we just gave was something similar to this. Oh, wait, that's right, it was. Hey, welcome back to PA Holes. We're reshooting Castlevania because the footage we had, I was boring and not in a real good mood.
Like usual.
Shut up, asshole. So, yeah, you know who the fuck we are.
Deal with it.
And as always.
Asshole.
Okay, so yeah, it's my turn to go this time.
Okay, no.
I'm all self I'm all self-conscious. My buddy was watching this, he's like, dude, the controller looks so tiny in your hands. It's like, fuck.
Because the controllers back then are tiny.
Whatever.
It's not your hands. At least you don't have small hands. Baby hands.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can do that backwards and walk. Get the knife you don't need. So yeah, Castlevania, man. If you haven't played this game, you...
Or I'm just fucking around, sorry.
You are missing out. This is a masterpiece. It's just...
Shoot the moon.
It's beautiful.
And here goes my favorite song.
My favorite song.
It's my favorite song.
You gotta have that fucking build up.
Alex had too much sugar today.
Yeah.
Actually, he's all pepped up because he got the Christmas spirit.
No, I got the anti-Christmas spirit. I'm a Christmas Scrooge.
He's a Grinch.
I'm a Grinch. Christmas is for kids. That's all I gotta say.
Should do a dude on this.
Yeah, they probably do have a dude on it. Jump.
This is annoying.
What is?
The fact that I died already.
Yeah.
You almost died.
Don't jinx me. I got this little leather whip. There we go. Now.
No, that was the whip's fault. I get it.
Yeah.
Normally I plow right through this, dude. Oh, there's the fucking meat I needed.
Finally, jump back into it.
Oh shit! It's getting serious.
Old Scully.
Scoliosis.
Old Scoliosis comes back one more time. Whipped in the face.
Got his boners.
Catch it. Catch it. Yeah. Yeah.
So you can kiss his finally chiseled, manly dad physique goodbye. Come Monday morning, I'm hitting the gym.
Mark the date, December 1st.
Come Monday morning, I'm hitting the gym.
2016. How, when's your guesstimated?
I'm gonna go to the gym Monday through Friday, 2 hours a day. Hopefully. Drop my kid off at 8 o'clock, head over to the gym and get back around 10:30. I got the rest of the day to do whatever the fuck I want. Back with this shitty fucking axe again.
Yeah.
Games like this, like Ghosts and Goblins and shit where you have to like hold an item.
Yeah.
They piss you off so bad because you get one good item, and then like when you get that item and you're used to having it, all of a sudden like, you're used to like hitting wherever the items drop, and you accidentally pick something up, like the whole fucking game feels like it's over.
Yeah. But like, luckily at the end, if you use that, like, you go down that little path that gets you the cross so you can fight Dracula with it.
Yeah.
No, it's not too bad. But yeah. It is kind of shitty, just like these, like, the dumbest.
Fucking
dumbest.
Marmosets.
Yeah.
Drop bears.
Drop bears, yeah. wallabies.
They look like armadillos, honestly.
Yeah, they look like porcupines. Like hedgehogs.
Dude, they're not blue.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. And they're not running around everywhere. Oh, well, there's one.
Watch out for fucking, Dr. Hyde.
Ooh. Ooh.
Mr. Jekyll.
Ooh. I can only...
Are they supposed to be zombies?
I don't know what... He's got, like, something hanging out of his mouth.
Why aren't you going off the screen? Are you, like, farming?
I'm going to whip him. Like, the only enemy that has, like, makes a sound is a... Ooh. Ooh.
That's the sound I make when I climax.
Yeah. I've heard it.
First
hand. Unfortunately.
Second hand.
Second hand.
Third hand.
So much filled with envy.
My heart's really in it.
Oh, shit.
Walking on a jello pudding.
Jello pudding. This fucking frog. Goddamn frogs.
Trying to remember what these were called in Simon's Quest. They had the Laurel Swamp. Something like that.
Shit. The shitty shallows.
So I really can't wait for fucking season 2 of Castlevania, whenever the fuck that comes out. 5 years from now.
Did they have a release date?
I don't know. I didn't even look. I might look here in a little bit. Do not lose that. Just hang on to it. It's the best item in this game.
Say that.
It's the best item in this game.
You say that, but it's not that easy.
It's the best item in the game.
You're the best.
I am the best item in the game.
That was skill, baby.
Man, I'm about to go out of the fucking car and get my energy gun.
One piece is a half a cup of...
That's why I'm going to eat three.
You drink a cup of... It just doesn't make sense.
Titties! Get them titties out!
Nipless.
Nudity in a NES game.
No nips, though.
I think in the Japanese version they actually were.
Well, yeah, it is Japan.
Don't quote me on that, but it just sounds correct.
It sounds correct. It's Japan.
They can't show pubic hair in cartoons, but they, they're more than about putting in video games.
They're in, like, any Metal Gear game you've played is this weird sexual...
Oh, yeah. Well, in Japan, there's actual vending machines where you can buy an actual high school girl's underwear.
Yeah, I've heard that. The rumors.
But then there's, like, a whole country of people that are so hung up on their sexual perversion that they won't have sex with each other. And they're actually, like... I'm going into, like, geopolitics. My bad.
Yeah, it's...
Forgive me. Nobody wants to hear about it. However, if I was given the opportunity to insert my DNA into the gene pool, I would gladly do it, you know, in the sake of humanity.
Yeah, because if they're going to pick somebody, they're going to pick you.
Yeah, dude. I'd pick me.
Well... So if you could fuck anybody, you'd pick you.
That's not what I said. Putting words in my mouth.
You're the ideal mate.
Putting words in my mouth. Yet again.
I'll put something in your mouth.
You see, now you're taking that whole gay route on it. I don't understand what your problem is. You're like a little sassed up over fucking Christmas.
Yeah.
You hit a little bit of traffic on the way to my house and you're all fucking
because
pissy.
Because every previous weekend it's been like... Smooth sailing. This weekend it's like every fucking cocksucker.
And then I have to listen to those fucking long ass text about how he fucking hates Christmas and what a piece of shit it is that people want to go shopping for their loved ones. But no, fuck them. He should be able to drive here without hitting any fucking traffic lights.
Exactly. It's all about me.
Everything's about you, Alex.
Well, it's...
Including that fart I just did. I know. This is what we're doing now.
Yeah, I just...
I know. I said it last playthrough, but you guys weren't privy to. The music to this level reminds me very much of Meridia. And that's... Sorry to interrupt myself. That's why the fucking Crossarang is the best fucking item in the game.
Preferred to...
But yeah, This reminds me of the music for Meridia and Super Metroid. And I know Super Metroid came out later, so possibly the composer stole it from them.
Could just have a slight influence.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Fuck.
Yeah, no. I was there for a second, I was going to egg you on, like, why aren't you getting that? Like, oh, wait. Because there's probably a fucking dildo in there. Replace your fucking cross.
The dildo weapon is actually...
It's the holy dildo.
The holy dildo. The golden dildo.
It's actually called a wooden stake. Back then they didn't have latex. You know, I'm really bringing the highbrow this episode, let me tell you.
Really stepping up your game.
I am, I'm stepping it up. Dude, you motherfucker.
I knew that wasn't there, because right down there, watch. Cross right. There. Well, I already have it, but if you didn't have it, it would be right there. I guarantee it. Like, this is fucking Men's Warehouse. I fucking guarantee
remember,
it.
Remember, we do not endorse Men's Warehouse. remember the fucking turtles with Leatherhead? I guarantee.
Oh, yeah.
This guy sucked. And the show ended up turning into fucking He-Man. It was just a fucking 30-minute-long week commercial. Every week there was a 30-minute commercial with a new fucking toy being advertised.
Yeah, well.
Hey, kids, the toy you don't own yet, Eastwing Duck. The Gecko Brothers.
Shit Bat and Twins.
No, Wingnut was awesome, dude. I love Wingnut. They had, like, Eastman and Laird had other comic books, and they would actually use that to plug some of their other comic stuff, like Usagi Yojimbo, Ace Wing Duck, Wingnut.
Yeah, I remember Usagi.
Usagi Yojimbo was, he was a samurai rabbit.
Yeah.
And I just found out recently, thanks to Red Letter Media, that there were, okay, so it's Kevin Eastman and Peter Laird, right?
I have no idea, but sure.
That's the name of the guys that created the Ninja Turtles.
Okay.
They have brothers named Peter Eastman and Kevin Laird. And who are the younger brothers of both. And they came out with their own comic trying to, like, go off the coattails of the Ninja Turtles. And they came out with a comic book called Horse Ninja.
Is it as good as it sounds?
It only had 9 issues, apparently, so it didn't go very far. But it did have a pilot show for a TV movie of the week that never got finished being produced. It's just a guy in a rubber horse mask. I guess now is as good a time as any. I probably should have done it in the beginning. Maybe I'll do a voiceover, too. But so over the last couple months, we've been in a group chat on Facebook with Tim from the Renaissance and Dan from Game Beaters, and they're pretty cool guys. And they gave us, both of them have given us some pretty nice shout-outs, and we've done the same. But they're definitely cool guys, and it's been nice meeting some other people in the community that are, you know, pretty awesome people. And, you know, if you like what we do, and you'll probably like what they do. Especially Tim, dude. Tim is a fucking master at Nintendo.
Yeah.
I've never, like, he's like autistic or something. I meant artistic. He's artistic.
What is that movie from? He's like, are you autistic? Yes, I'm very artistic. Oh, fuck. I'll tell you when you
cut it in. Yeah, I can't remember.
It's 21 or 22 Jump Street.
That's right, yeah.
Are you autistic? Yes, I'm very autistic.
Seriously, and something I thought was cool. I mean, yeah, we joke about stuff. I have a sense of humor. I'm not completely politically correct. And, you know, if you can't laugh at stuff, even your own misfortune, then, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You grow the fuck up. Honestly, like, I think the South Park guys are doing something really cool. They're doing for their Giving Tuesday. I did Children's Miracle Network and I only raised $45, which kind of pisses me off. But they're doing a thing for autism, And basically, they were letting people become part of the townsfolk.
Oh, yeah, I think I saw that.
Yeah, and it's for autism.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
You know, but they make fun of autistic stuff all the time. And it's not meant to be, like, hateful.
No, no.
It's just meant, you know, it's something that, anything that makes people uncomfortable, I mean, at some level, is funny.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think that it's cool when, you know, laugh at other people's misfortunes, but at the same time, you know, you can laugh at stuff.
Yeah. I just like swinging on that whip.
This fucking month has sucked for me. I haven't wanted to do shit.
Yeah. Wow.
I've been working us like a dog, you know, at work, but now I'm laid off.
Yay.
Plenty of fucking time to edit. No, not yay. But yeah, we'll figure it out.
Kinda yay.
Figure it out. All my plans of, all my serious schemes and plans have backfired and imploded on themselves, but. Whatever.
That's why, if you're like me, you don't make plans.
I don't make plans usually, and everybody's, oh, you need to make plans. And so I try and make plans, and then none of them work. So
you can't be disappointed if you...
I normally just go with the flow and figure the shit out as it happens.
You can go...
With the flow. Which I can't sing. I can't sing right now, dude, or else I would be singing Queens of the Stone Age. And I love that song. I could go get my guitar and play it.
You'll get your voice back one day.
Oh, I'm hoping this carnivora stuff... It's supposed to boost your immune system.
Oh, okay.
Did I say immune?
Immune.
Immune. Nice. That is why the fucking boomerang is the shit.
Especially with the threefer.
I had a boss we used to... Derek used to call him Dragon's Breath. He right to his face. He like... God damn, Mike, you got fucking dragon's breath, motherfucker. Brush your teeth. Like, all the fucking time you work in the doc office. That motherfucker was a pain in the ass. He's so stupid. He'd just sit there with like this blank look on his face. You'd ask him a question, and he'd just be like, Mike, I just spilled a whole crate of fucking Jimmy Dean sausages down in pee aisle. What do I do? Probably just gonna call Dave and have him pick it up. Thanks, asshole.
Yeah, there's a guy I worked with who drank.
What the fuck is that guy staring at you for? He's peeping on you.
Drank way too much coffee, and he was a close talker.
So that, oh, that shit breath.
Coffee breath.
I had a fucking, he was a fucking, when I was a kid, scout master. He always walk around with coffee and smoking cigarettes and had a skull in his mouth. And he'd be like, yeah, like talking to you, and it just smelled like a big fucking turd was like coming out of his mouth after every fucking he'd be like, every syllable, a big fucking turd popping out of his fucking mouth, like, oh, dude, you stink. I think when I was a dickhead as a kid, too. I think I actually told him, like, dude, your breath fucking stinks, dude. Like, here I am, like, 14 years old, telling this full-grown man, like, your breath smells like a straight turd. You should go flush your mouth.
Fucking dog turd, man. Get the fuck out of here.
Go flush your mouth.
How am I supposed to learn anything from you, fucking shit breath?
All right.
Big skull.
Alex is whooping ass. I'm almost afraid to, like, ask for my turn. Jesus.
Yeah.
Fucking walnuts popping out everywhere.
Walnuts? I just thought they were, like, red... blood vessel.
Oh, this part sucks dick. It's where the fucking room spins.
Mode 7.
Yeah, it goes mode 7 and fucking spins on your ass.
Oh, yeah. Just hang. It's so slow. You just gonna sit.
3 hours later.
No. Once this level's open, we'll break. Because I think the next... Yeah, I think we got one more. And then it's the... Jackie's.
Oh my god, really? What are you... What's your fucking plan here, dude?
What do you mean?
Oh, you really did? Oh, okay. Never mind. See, I would have tried to jump into that.
No, you don't jump down the hole. You gotta wait for you have to wait for the whole room to spin, and then you gotta wait for the platform to come out.
Forgot about this. Jesus.
I remember as a kid playing this, I'm like, oh man, I guess I got dropped down the hole. And I couldn't figure it out. And I was like, oh. Because it takes so long.
Ever. It's like the load screen for like fucking like Wolfenstein or something. Yeah. On a 386. Not on a modern computer. This 286.
This is one of my favorite parts too. This
is mode 7.
Yeah.
Straight up. Like both This was basically put in just to showcase it, what the Super Nintendo could do, so they could dump this part into a commercial.
Yeah, it's cool.
Like, oh, it's a new Castlevania.
New Castlevania, look, it spins!
With new Super Nintendo graphics.
Look, it spins!
Nintendo does fucking do it. Nintendo
does. Fuck you, Sega. You fucking cocksuckers. What do you got, a blue hedgehog? Get the fuck out of here. Damn it.
Too busy fucking jerking Sonic off. So, at some point, we should play what they actually refer to as Castlevania, Super Castlevania Lite, which would be Castlevania Bloodlines on the Sega,
which
you said you've never played.
Yeah.
Which also is the first Castlevania game, to my knowledge, that doesn't feature a Belmont.
Ooh.
It actually features characters from the Bram Stoker books, which is actually really fucking stupid.
Oh. To say oh to everything. Oh! That's a risky click right there. I don't want to get rid of this. I've had this cross rang for 8 hours now.
Don't get squished.
Dun, dun, dun. This fucking
music, you know how bad you'd have been fucked if that was like holy water right there? Because if you didn't get it and you tried to go back not to get it, you'd have been squished. And it would have been like, well, I have to take it.
Yeah.
So you should probably just stop fucking hitting candles in here. You have 73 hearts. but they're there.
But they're there. Someone lit them. Someone took the time.
And it's my job as the parishioner of this house to extinguish all the candles. Oh, you're fucked.
I am fucked. Fuck
what
me.
What are you doing? Too busy.
You got me talking about goddamn candles.
I got you. You're too busy fucking trying to whip candles. You actually stopped and were like, I'm going to whip that candle.
This is your fault, I blame you.
It's not my fucking fault.
It is now.
Get up, the motherfucker. Nice.
Now you're going to get squished.
I so am. All right, let's take a break here. Take a break. Pause. So yeah, we're gonna continue this in part two.
All right.
All right. Thank you very much.
Peace.
All right. No, it's coming.